What is it?
Do you want to see your surprise?
Can we wait? Should we show me on the show?
I'm already recording. Will is about to show up to my house.
With the surprise?
Nope.
Yo!
I didn't realize this was a surprise.
I'm so happy.
Yeah, I knew.
I was just asked if I wanted to be here.
I'm touched that you are.
I'm so upset.
Or not upset. I had such like a shitty day at work. This is such a nice surprise.
There you go.
Ever since I met Hunter, I was like, I love Hunter.
He's that kind of guy.
Yeah.
I'm a handsome one.
You have a voice, William.
Not that you're like handsome. You're just great. I love you.
Oh, God, we can't let this dick sucking continue.
You're handsome, too, and I love you.
We can't let this continue.
I'm in the picture.
All of this emotion is, like, weirding me out.
Yeah, we got to go.
So is your name Ramen or Ramon?
Ramon.
Okay, Ramon. What's up, bro?
Switch the O in the A.
No.
That would...
I took the plunge and had the time of my life.
I finally took the plunge. You know what? Feels great.
I got something special for the intro for year 5.
Oh, that's what we're doing. We're singing. Y'all don't know about this. Watch me. Come on.
Take it out.
What's up, guys?
Yeah.
Let's move, guys. I'm hyped.
What's up, guys? Welcome to The Plunge. Today is a day. Joining me, as always, my lovely husband, Riley. Say what's up, dude.
What's up? Welcome to Year 5. Ramon looks appalled. What's up?
I'm not appalled. Don't tell people that.
You should be. I'm appalled at him every day.
I looked at Will before I hit play. I was like, I got something ready to go.
I haven't heard that in a while.
Even if I did look appalled, it doesn't mean anything. I always look appalled. So I'm not. It's whatever. The point has nothing to do with.
It's not personal.
Yeah, exactly.
Year 5.
If you can't tell, we have special guest Ramon today. And joining us, loosely as always, we have Will. What team would you like to be on today?
I'm on team never tight, always loose.
Naturally.
Yeah, you heard it here. Always tight, never loose.
Other way. Dyslexia, Hunter.
Always loose, never tight?
Always loose, never tight.
What?
Yeah, that's what I said. Always loose. I'm never tight.
Stay
moist.
I
know that. And always stay moist is just a given.
Will, did you hear me hit that for you at the end of the past few episodes?
Dude, yeah. I have on one of them. Have not seen the past couple, though, so...
That's okay.
Okay.
I just want you to know I've been hitting that shit for you.
Dude, thank you
every time.
Yeah, every time I leave a podcast, I say stay moist.
Gorgeous.
Ooh. Gorgeous.
Yeah, what's up, everybody?
And you're the Hunt.
I am the Hunt.
Are we working a new intro this year since the accolades are on sabbatical? Will, the accolades are on sabbatical.
I don't know what sabbatical means.
I know.
Okay.
That's okay.
What does that mean, man?
It's fine. I don't know what the accolades are. So.
Sabbatical is like
a vacation.
Like, yeah, essentially.
But a long one.
A very long one.
Yeah, like
you don't know when it ends.
Yeah, it has no end in sight.
Okay.
Well, this one we do know when it ends. On precisely episode like 263. 261, yeah.
269?
261.
261.
Yeah. It's the start of season 6 is when it returns. Hunter's taking a year off.
Is that
no?
Like, is that like a
the
brand?
The accolades are taking.
Sorry,
a year
yeah.
Off.
Hunter's here. He's well and good. The accolades are off. For
accolades
a year.
Taking a year off. Gotcha.
Yeah.
We should
yeah,
have the exactly. fans try and do it then.
That? Well, the speaking of that, the fans are trying to hit the accolades.
Ban him. Ban him.
No, don't ban him from the Twitch chat. He's doing okay. He's a mod. I don't know if you can ban him.
I might be able to ban him.
I don't think you can ban him. Hey, before we get too deep in the episode, I want to plug something. We're selling 50-50 tickets for the charity cornhole tournament. So if you want to get a ticket, you can Venmo me. You can see me in person. They're $1 for one, $5 for six, or, I mean, $20 for just six for four bundles. So if you want to enter the 50-50, the drawing September 10th, so hit me up. Yeah, that's all about that. Come to the cornhole tournament on September 10th.
Yeah, come
cool.
to that cornhole tournament. You like corn? Come to it.
is it going to be because I know cornhole is the game, right?
I'll
make corn on that.
Is it going to be corn at the cornhole tournament?
I mean, we could probably make that happen.
We could probably swing that, yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, see, there you go.
I'll bring some fresh corn. I mean, throw it on the grill.
Do some cob, corning on the cob, or loose corn?
I'll cob it up, dude. No, no, loose
that is
corn.
Such a callback.
Let's get you know. Loose corn
what was that?
Doesn't
episode two?
Episode
yeah.
one.
So early.
Loose corn doesn't exist.
Yeah.
Is that really the name of the first episode?
Yes.
Hell yeah.
I'm actually shook.
Me too. We've come a long way with the corn people. Now we're doing a corn podcast. I mean, a corn tournament. Like
the number one corn cast.
No, stop it.
No accolades.
Hunter, you can't. Please.
Shut up, corn.
You'll never get better if you don't go cold turkey.
Is that this year's story arc? Is that the accolades have made me sick?
Yeah, dude. You're on.
He's
You're
addicted
ill.
To the accolades.
He can't stop. That's not an insult, by the way. We are homosexuals. I was just telling someone.
It's Pride Month.
I was at a party before
it
this.
It is Pride Month, yes.
I was at a party before this, and I was like, yeah, I'm married to a man. And then I continued on it with a different story, and two guys off in the corner were like, wait. Like 10 minutes down, they're like, did you say you were married to a man? I was like, we'll get back to it.
We'll circle back. It comes full inner circle.
Did you ever come back to it?
I did. They're like, is it
oh.
like, I was, they're like, is it real? And I was like, yeah, we kissed on the internet for not that much money, but we thought it was a lot of money at the time.
Dude,
like, oh.
Can I tell you, almost every single person I try to tell that to that listens to this podcast, I'm like, yeah, you didn't know they're married? They're like, yeah. I'm like, what do you think the number one gay marriage podcast means?
It's us.
You think that's just nothing? Like, we're repping that shit. God, get out of here.
It's just facts. Mom, get out of my room.
You never see two guys kiss? God.
We did kiss.
A certain flavor to
we
the
did
show.
Kiss.
I just got to say
Hunter,
that.
We did kiss for appallingly little money. In retrospect.
In retrospect, I would have kissed you for less.
That's also
well,
true.
You know, there you go.
Yeah.
There you go.
I mean, I feel like that should be an emote, is us making out.
I don't agree.
I don't know how much I agree
how
with that
money?
Either.
For what? To make out again? At next
no,
year's?
No, like, make out. You have never actually made out.
No, we just kissed. How
so
much How
out.
Much raise for us to make out?
I don't know if we
I don't
want to
do that.
20? 20 racks?
20,000.
20 Gs?
No, because that's going to happen.
I was going to say, we've done the impossible.
Pick,
I guess.
Pick the price.
35 oh, Gs?
That's still.
How about 50?
Do you let's, think that's in the realm?
Let's put it at 50.
Okay, so
dude,
like, turn
we're
how
married.
Much...
Dude, we're married.
Hey, what's just because you're married doesn't mean you have to make okay. out.
That's fair.
Like, thank you.
You're very right, though. You're very right.
Why are you trying noise. To make out with me?
Because you're handsome, like Skyler said earlier.
I don't know how much I don't. This whole marriage thing.
Dude, you're about to me. Be a real doctor. We're about to make bank.
He's got you.
We ain't got no dumbass kids either. We're gonna.
Why
be...
can you say that I'm gonna be a doctor soon? But whenever I say it, you're like, ah, fuck you.
Because you're my husband. Shrimp gang.
Shrimp gang. Is Adam hitting us with the Yunk Tom Cruise?
That was me. I hit us with Yunk Cruise.
Okay.
Shout out to the dads.
Yeah. What?
Tomorrow's Father's Day.
Oh.
Well, like
wait.
Yes. Day
Will, what was your errand?
What was my errand?
This is a good one, but it has to up because we've already done 10K.
What is it?
Adorable. 10K to get tattoos with each other's names and hearts.
That's very
I would do that one. Yeah, I would.
Do that one.
15? Do we just up it to 15 to give us something higher to get to? 12? I think 12 is almost 12's, a good point.
12's good.
Like if we can repeat last year 12, with a little five. Bit
yeah,
on top.
I think 15 would get more people. I would love. I would donate $5,000 of my own money to get from the 10 to the 15 to see you guys.
We'd have
tattoos.
To do it live on air too. We'd have to have a tattoo
that's
artist facts, at the ready.
Beautiful.
Yeah.
Yep.
Yeah, I think that one's locked
one.
In. All right,
I have one.
Yeah, 15. So 15 for tattoo with each other's names and hearts. Ramon, what are your thoughts on this?
We'll come to your home.
I mean, go for it. You know, yeah, I'm all for it.
Ramon, for context, we do a charity live stream every December.
You told me about, well, the last one.
Yeah. We did 11? We did 11K last year. So, like,
oh, okay.
15's not out of question, but it might be enough to, we feel like we keep plateauing and then we double the year before. So, like, maybe I'm just talking crazy, but I feel like we've plateaued again. So maybe this is what it takes to get us.
What do you mean
edge.
You think we've plateaued? We haven't even, like, had this year start.
Well, I'm saying for last year, like, every year, I think I'm like, well, no, we
you
can't.
You do realize the cornhole tournament is going to raise so much money.
He's I'm right, not counting though. Those towards this.
Hey, can I also say that I had COVID during this and all my work friends did not get to donate to that? So,
that
like,
has.
Okay, true.
Hunter, I want to tell you. I want you to tell him what's fundamentally wrong with that statement.
That they had COVID and couldn't donate.
I don't know.
No, he thinks that because he had COVID, his friends didn't donate.
I didn't get to participate and tell them about it, so because I wasn't there, they didn't care enough to
donate. Okay.
Yeah.
That's more fair, but also.
Yeah. I'm so pissed I had COVID during that. It was a fun thing. It looked like I was watching it the whole time.
Sad watching it.
It really
do you
was.
Think this year we get COVID again?
Of course.
So.
Nah.
No, I'm just kidding.
Ramon, also for context, we've gone 0-2 against COVID in our two charity live streams the last 2 years.
Jeez.
COVID's going to end. Like, it's going to be eradicated, and then it's still going to be like,
it's still going to pop.
Ah, you thought.
When we were halfway through recording that 1 year, and Riley walks in and goes, "Hey, so someone from my office has COVID," and we were all like sitting there.
I would like to emphasize it was not Riley who came in and said that; it was me.
Because I had a panic attack in the parking lot.
I saw it in your face, though, Riley.
I thought that like both of you came in and like sat down like mom and dad.
We both came in and I couldn't speak.
Okay. Riley sat down and then I daddied up and handled business.
Well, you goddamn did. We were wrapping up a segment and I was like, hey, hon.
Yeah, dude, I was talking, I'll never forget it. I was talking about bee poop.
Boop.
Which, if you were wondering, that's what wax is.
Oh, yeah, I remember that. I remember, dude, I fucking remember that. That was awesome.
I did too. That was a banging segment.
Yeah, it was.
Bro, Glignar would have thought that was one of the most banging podcast segments. Did anybody get that?
No,
I did not.
Yeah, that's my solo episode.
Oh, I thought you were trying to set up like a suck my dick joke or something.
Dude,
that's why.
Yeah, speaking of Glignar, Hunter, you're with me on this one. I've been super into history lately, and I think this podcast is just going to turn into a history show.
Dude, I have always been into history because I just watch a lot of Jeopardy. History's crazy as fuck.
You should buy a lot of outdated editions of history books and
see what's
wrong they are.
Oh my god.
That'd be a good segment.
The best thing ever.
Skylar, if you commandeer this,
sure.
We will turn that into a segment for sure.
You. I'll show up with like 76 history books.
I love that idea.
Thank you.
Jack says losing Will was such a loss for the live stream. Pure content.
I
strongly agree. I was so upset.
I mean,
be there.
Yeah. Yeah. That'd be tough.
Oh, but I've been writing some notes about my favorite dictators and how much of knuckleheads they are. And I'd like to share some of my facts.
Are you going to be bringing up Kim Jong-un?
I'm actually going to be bringing up his papa, Kim Jong-il, who was way funnier.
Was he sick? That guy.
That guy's a real.
That dictator of mine.
That guy's a real knucklehead.
That
all
guy's
right,
sick, nasty, bro.
Dude, he's funny. He killed so many millions of people. Okay, I need, before we get into these segments, to emphasize, not funny. Dude's funny as fuck. Okay. Do you want to hear,
hell, bro?
You want to hear about Ill?
I would love to hear about Ill.
Yo, he sounds okay.
Me too. All
right, let me get my notebook out.
You've actually been taking notes.
I've been taking diligent notes. Okay. So Ill, right?
You're a clown.
So Ill loved movies. Okay.
You've already told me this one, but yeah, I'm excited.
So Kim Jong Il loved movies, but you know it's not allowed in North Korea. Movies.
All right.
So the propaganda machine, they don't show movies. If they do, they're like propaganda movies that only they put out.
Yeah.
He had the largest movie collection in the world. Bollywood, like North American movies. All movies. He loved movies. His favorites were like Rambo and shit. He
could not get enough.
He could not get enough of movies. He was obsessed with movies. He in his mind, he wrote the like 40 best plays of all time. Okay.
Well, he probably wrote the 40 best plays in North Korea.
No, he wrote the 40 best plays of all time. All of them would put any of the top plays ever to shame.
Shakespeare didn't know shit.
Yeah, shit compared to all Ill. All right. Now,
okay.
This guy's out here.
So he wrote the best plays. He found himself. He was an expert producer. The only problem was, right? Wanted to make movies. His problem. Illy's old problem, that knucklehead. North Koreans aren't creative. So, because they've banned creativity.
Yeah. I just heard about that.
Wait. Go back.
Yeah.
They ban creativity?
Well, I don't know if you know this, but North Korea is not a fun place.
So, what do you mean by ban creativity?
So,
they
Will.
Took
you
away.
Hey, Will,
do
Will,
anything,
if you,
fun.
In your current place, like you right now, went to North Korea, right?
Okay.
You'd be executed immediately.
In front of people for fun.
Yeah.
Why? Because I have an imagination?
Yes.
Yes.
Well, that's outrageous. I don't find that.
And
yeah, all right. You're getting it now. You're understanding.
Did you say that's outrageous?
Will's
outrageous.
Understanding tyranny.
About a dictatorship.
Yeah. Will's Whoa. Understanding tyranny one statement at a time. Okay.
I just think that's ridiculous, man.
Man, you're going to be real.
Hold on.
You're
going to
be real
hold
bummed
on.
When I tell you about the Germans.
Oh man, I need history lessons too.
Yeah, well, that's what
Amazing.
I'm here for.
Not just science.
This is what I'm here to do. All right. So
Welcome
this knucklehead, right? No one's creative. Okay. No one in his country is creative because he's banned it. He's
legally,
like,
they are not creative.
So, like, well, literally, he was like, "Man, all these directors and actresses are shit. What?
Damn it!
What the fuck,
Freaking
man?
Losers!
Yeah. What the hell?" He's pissed that no one's good at acting because he's banned learning how to be good at acting. So you know what he does, this knucklehead? He goes and kidnaps South Korea's biggest actress and movie director.
Why does he do that?
So that's right!
So he can have them make him movies that he can produce.
Yo, this guy's insane, man.
Imagine hearing about that.
Imagine if today, right? Oh, all right? Old son Illy son.
Old son Ill.
He kidnapped Scarlett Johansson and like Michael Bay. And then no one did anything for like 6 years about it. Cause he was like, they're gonna make me movies.
They're gonna make a bunch of just short films.
They're gonna
me.
Make me movies. It's gonna be wonderful.
It's gonna be wonderful.
It's gonna be huge.
They're gonna be huge.
Do you think he'd steal a director too?
He stole the director. Yes.
Oh.
Yeah.
He's okay. The producer. He's the best producer in the world.
Okay.
I need to get that.
Does he star in the movie?
No, he produces the movies. Just, he's a creative mind. Okay.
Oh, that's unbelievable.
Didn't he also want to be a cowboy?
Probably because he loved westerns.
Sounds like Lil Nas X at this point. Like,
westerns are
what?
Lil Nas X.
I got nothing.
I don't know how to.
So this is a good time. So I was.
Nope. You're gonna go on that thought because I'm not done. But you need to extrapolate.
So I don't know what I meant by that. I was just trying to relate.
Okay.
But, like, I was at the bar the other day, and I said a joke that, and it fell so far flat that this guy literally looked at me, looked down at his phone, and he didn't say a word for the rest of the time that I sat next to him.
Oh my God, no! But it was so bad.
It was
so
one of the worst jokes I've ever said
this
in my
guy
life.
Next to us. So
where?
This we were at Romano's in Litchfield.
Okay, you're at a bar.
Yep, yeah, kay. Like sitting at the bar downstairs. So okay. This guy,
I really fucked this up.
Will and I are at like the two corner bars and the two corner seats at the bar, and then the guy sits at like the cap of the bar, so he's like kind of facing us. And we're not talking to him at all, but he shows
this,
us.
Hold on. Let me add this part. So this guy, all of a sudden, out of the fucking blue, sitting by himself, decides to reach over and show us a meme.
A meme.
Without even saying
that,
anything.
That alone.
He sounds like a pretty cool guy.
I need to take this over, though. Because Will, this guy shows us this meme, and it's this kid.
Is it what? Was it a good meme?
No.
Okay. It was a terrible meme.
It's this like little kid that has like a giant head.
Sounds pretty good.
No.
A latex head.
You didn't even know what that meant.
I know,
Will.
I didn't know,
so,
but I know.
Shut up. Okay, but anyways, so it's like this little kid, like with a Jimmy Neutron size, like head, and it's like a bald head. And this guy shows us this meme, and the like caption above it is he keeps going into the store every day, but layers a new head of
verbal
latex.
Meme.
Huh?
So I'm
verbal meme.
Yeah.
So I'm gonna
shut up. For the love of God.
I am enjoying this.
That's real right there.
Okay. So every time he goes into the store, he adds a new layer of latex so his head gets bigger. Whatever.
Where does he get the latex
but
from?
I don't know.
What do you
not
mean
described.
A latex head?
That's what I said.
Listen, I have so many more facts
like
about
like a bald cat. I don't know how to explain this, but whatever. But this guy shows it to us. I read it, obviously. Will just looks at it and smiles.
I bet Will goes,
okay. No,
let me add.
Hold on.
He
didn't even
hold
read
on.
It.
Skylar, let me add. So I looked at the thing, did not understand it, so I did one of those. It nodded because I'm like, I don't know this fucking dude. I'm not going to pretend like I know what the hell this meme means. So I just nodded and I laughed. And then the dude looked at me after Skylar laughed, and Skylar was like, did you not get it? And the guy goes, well, did you even read it? And I was like, no. He goes, typical guy. And I was like, what?
But because it said something about latex, I don't know.
He keeps throwing rubbers on. All right.
No, Will said something about like a
So I said, so I looked at him and I was like, oh, yeah, so like a dominatrix type, right? And then he looked at me. And I don't know what I said, but I was like, yeah, it was like a dominatrix.
Said a dominatrix.
Yeah, it was like a dominatrix
and
kind of thing.
Of
you know what I mean?
None of this was about sex. Not like he decides to bring that up.
Yo, this guy looked at me really uncomfortably.
Yeah,
I'm
and then he didn't look again. So, all right, let me tell you the next thing about Kim Jong-il.
Yeah, go right ahead.
You really been waiting for this, huh?
Yeah, I don't know where that went. That went nowhere, but I needed to reel it back into Captain Il. All right.
There it is, folks.
All right, Il.
Idiot. Sick.
Ready? His next thing.
Yeah.
He's golfed once, right?
Okay.
He's the best golfer in the world.
Of course.
By far. He golfed one time. He picked up a golf club, right? He shot like a minus 37 with 11 holes in ones. And then he never golfed again because it was just too easy.
What, Kim Jong-il?
Kim Jong-il.
Oh, Kim Jong-il.
Yeah, Un's
okay.
Dad. Come on.
Right. Okay. Yep.
He's just that good at golf.
I mean, sounds like he should play again.
No, he doesn't need to.
It sounds
no
like
reason.
Tiger Woods needs to face him.
He can't do that.
I think Tiger Woods would win. I don't know, right?
I mean, that's besides the point, technically.
This man owns an entire country. He doesn't need to play for the PGA.
Do you want? All right,
that's
my,
also true.
My favorite ill fact, right? Favorite ill fact by far. Whole country was in a drought, right? A famine. A famine that killed millions.
So many people.
Millions of people. But they were like feasting in the government. They were feasting like kings still.
Yeah.
They sent in from Italy. They were importing some animals to breed and then to have some food so the famine would end. Okay. They sent six oversized rabbits.
Why'd they do that?
So they could then breed oversized rabbits and then feed rabbit as the...
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay.
Yeah.
Kim Jong-il intercepted the rabbits on their way to the farm and ate them all.
What?
So then the country...
What an asshole.
The guy. Country then continued...
This is next level
to
bully.
...to famine. It just
He's
died.
A bully, dude. That's
because he ate all of the rabbits.
Dude, he could have had so much more rabbit.
He
could have, yeah. Bunny,
that one, they like, I've been listening to this podcast called Real Dictators, and I was listening to it at work, and I was just like passively listening to it. And then they just threw that out there casually, and I had to like rewind and be like, did I hear that right? Yeah. And then they're like, yeah, they brought these rabbits in, and this dude was like, nom, 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 nom.
That's just so messed up, man. Like, you're already a dictator. Why you gotta eat the rabbits? These people are starving. These people are starving.
Bro, so he sounds like rabbits. Lenny from Of Mice and Men. I wanna eat the rabbit.
We'll talk about Stalin next week, but Stalin...
Dude, Stalin's a psychopath. He is
smart
literally
smart guy. Let me tell you,
the only person, like, not above, but like,
he's a but he his casualties.
Oh, he might be worse than
his casualties is like 30 million.
Yeah, insane.
Just to tease next week, I think it's the funniest shit ever that in Russia they don't do anything about prisoners in exile. They just drop them in Siberia.
Hey, dude, yeah. Siberia is just prison.
Hey, been there.
They drop them in Siberia.
Been to Siberia.
Do you know what you can do when you're exiled in Siberia? You can just
Anything.
Fucking walk back to Russia.
What?
Joseph Stalin got exiled to Siberia twice.
And he just
and said
back.
No.
The first time he just went, I'm just going back. He just walked back to Russia. The second time.
The man has conviction.
He does.
Bad.
Seriously.
They really just don't have a plan over there, do they?
Yeah, and then the second time he got exiled, Russia was getting ready for the war, and they're like, damn, we don't have enough soldiers. You know where we could get soldiers? Let's go round up the Siberian exiles.
Amazing.
Ramon, we have a question for you from our chat from Adam Simmons. He said, how many Tom Hanks would it take to kill a wild grizzly bear?
I do love this question.
Me too.
I'm going to go with 7.
That's a good answer.
I like that.
That's a 1-to-1 ratio.
No, you think
like
Tom... No, you're thinking Tom
Hanks,
Cruise.
Though?
He said Tom Hanks.
Oh, yeah. Not enough Tom Hanks in the world could kill bear.
You don't think so?
I feel like...
No. We had this conversation on the stream. Tom Cruise, 1-to-1 ratio.
No.
100%.
Tom Cruise. No.
Okay.
Tom Cruise, confirmed, stronger than a bear.
No.
He might be.
He
might be.
I don't think that's true.
I mean, who do you think would win in a fist fight? Tom Cruise or
I would hope anybody else because I would love to see Tom Cruise get punched in the face.
What's National Treasure? What's his
Nicolas
name?
Cage.
Nicolas Cage.
Tom Cruise and Nicolas Cage. They're both
Oh, see, Nicolas Cage is like 6'4", and Tom
I don't
Cruise
know who
is like 5
that.
Foot 3, but I think Tom Cruise would win it.
Dude, Tom Cruise might win that.
I think
you should
thinking.
All watch Willy's Wonderland. It's a Nicolas
no,
Cage.
No, cuz that's what I was thinking too. I think Yeah, I'd have to go. I have to go with Nicolas Cage.
I know.
Nicolas Cage is sweeping that.
Here's my thing. So
tell me your thing.
Nicolas Cage right now has a movie coming out about a super crazy fan obsessed with him, and he's making a movie about it. I swear to God.
Yeah.
My brother worked on that movie.
Did he really?
Yeah.
That's cool.
It's been out for like 6 months.
Has it really?
Like 2 months maybe?
I have not seen a single preview for that movie.
I've seen a lot. It got rave reviews and then was like
Oh, I got to watch that movie then. I didn't even know that.
Yeah.
Well, good for Nicolas
Cage. With
Pedro
Pascal, The Mandalorian.
Oh, is that who it was?
He's the co-star, yeah. Oh, he's nice. The rich guy who pays Nicolas Cage to come make a movie as Nicolas Cage.
Wouldn't have known that.
Yeah.
Wouldn't have known that.
Yes,
I'm
the Mandalorian.
Behind on things, aren't I?
No.
No. Not
well, you said you had some crazy shit to talk about. Wait, Ramon, how many TCs? How many Tom Cruises?
Oh, it is Tom Cruise?
Yeah.
Two
Tom Cruises for one bear?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yes.
Grizzly bear?
Yes, grizzly.
I would at least say 4.
That's not that wild. That's not that insane.
Yeah, but, like, I feel like you need one for each arm.
Oh, see, I was going one for distraction and one for attack.
Yeah. Okay.
The distraction's going to be dead in 4 seconds. Grizzly bears are so terrifying. They're
not to Tom Cruise.
To anybody.
Not to Tom Cruise.
Not to Tom.
Not to Tom Cruise.
His front tooth is
in the center of his face. I know it pisses me off too.
No, but that scares the grizzly bear away. That's why.
Listen,
Tom Cruise is not 6'7".
Once I found out that this dude goes out of his way to do most, if not all, of his stunts on Mission Impossible, yeah, and I guess Maverick too.
But also, he broke his leg doing that and then halted production for like 6 months.
He did.
Yeah.
He did. Yeah.
Why? Don't you badmouth Tom Cruise. I'll get him to fight you.
I feel like this is like the Family Guy Liam Neeson thing where I'm like, I will fight.
Well, what you're missing is grizzlies are scared of TC. That's just a common fact.
Do you think a grizzly bear would even fight Liam Neeson?
I don't think they'd even come.
I don't think he would bother.
The bear, Liam Neeson.
Both.
I think
no,
Liam Neeson
they
would
wouldn't
like,
have.
Yeah.
I mean, they heard about him from the wolves that he boxed.
This is a good plunge pick.
You have my daughter.
So there was a whole debate on the internet of gorillas versus grizzly bears. It's obviously grizzly bears, but then it's...
No, it's obviously gorillas.
It's not obviously gorillas. It's obviously grizzly bears.
Gorillas are very strong.
So are grizzly bears.
Yo, I'm taking grizzlies, man.
So this was an internet debate. We've talked it ad nauseum on our plunge plays on Twitch, but this is a good plunge picks of humans you would take one-to-one. Or animals, I suppose. No, humans. Just humans against a grizzly bear. Plunge picks. Hunter, who's it brought to you by?
You are looking for comfortable and affordable streetwear that has their unique designs and remakes of old logos, head on over to official.com. That is O-H, fish like a fish. L is in let's do this plunge picks.
Oh, Ramon, plunge picks. I forget your new... Oh, I finally get the latex meme. It just keeps blowing his head. Why are they saying latex? They just keep photoshopping his head bigger.
Dude, I'm gonna be honest. Stupid meme. That guy was trying to
like
make
it.
Conversation.
I don't like
know.
That meme at all.
For somebody
yeah.
at the end of a bar to show you that.
Yeah. Ramon, plunge picks. It's a draft, snake draft style pick game. And that's it. We'll let you.
I'm ready.
Okay.
Yeah. All right. Who wants to start?
I can.
All right. So it goes: Skylar, Will, Ramon, or wait, my camera. Skylar, Will, Riley, Hunter, Ramon.
Okay.
Skylar, you're up.
I'm going to say The Undertaker.
Like
the, yep. Oh, from
like the WWE superstar?
Yep.
The dead man?
Yep.
All right.
Is this the
he could take a grizzly bear for
take
sure.
A grizzly bear.
He is a grizzly bear of a human. That's when you talk about a grizzly bear.
I wasn't thinking WWE superstars, but this
now,
has just opened up a whole new
go.
Lane.
That's what I thought. I literally thought of him and somebody else from WWE
in a cage match.
Yep.
All right, Will.
Now I have a question before I make a statement.
Of course.
can I use monkeypox?
What?
Like you no, just want like a small boy with monkeypox?
No, like he gets monkeypox and that's what takes.
You'd have to give him monkeypox, so it would have to be someone
it's
with monkeypox.
All right, never mind then.
Okay,
never mind then.
You can take monkeypox, but it has to be a person with monkeypox.
No. I'm gonna take Grogu.
Baby Yoda?
Yeah.
Okay. There's so many Jedis who were like already trained that. You could have picked, but instead you picked...
But it's the limitless potential of Grogu.
Okay.
Sure. I get it.
All right.
It's a big commitment right there.
Okay. Yeah, it's a future. It's
for that.
All right.
You have to keep all the Grogu.
It's a long-term investment.
Yeah, for sure. A lifetime of safety.
Okay. I'm going to go with Tom Cruise.
The clear number one, just saying.
Yeah, the obvious number one. TC
like actual 1-1.
TC versus GZB. Easy pick. TC all day.
All day.
Okay, Hunt.
I'm gonna take Michael Bublé.
He's gonna sing him into a.
He sings him his Christmas album.
Yeah.
Done.
That's a good pick. All right, Ramon, so you're up for two because it's snake draft. So you're the last pick of the first round and first pick of the second round.
Okay.
Yep.
Well, I'm going to go with Sarah Connor.
Okay, the Tomb Raider?
No.
That's Laura Croft.
Oh, I'm sorry.
The Terminator.
Sorry. That was
Mikey's probably so disappointed.
He's
right
so
now.
Mad right now.
Okay.
And then your second pick.
My second one. I'm going to go with the wrestling thing and go with Mark Henry.
Mark Henry would fuck yeah. up.
That's such an elite pick.
That's such the world's god, strongest yeah. man.
Oh my god.
Damn. All right, Hunt, you're up. That's a tough one to
yeah,
follow up.
It is.
I'm going to take the guy who shrinks. From
the
boys.
Boys season episode one, season three.
Yeah. Yeah.
It's right up the grizzly bear's asshole.
Oh,
or penis.
The boys.
Yeah.
This team yep. episode.
Always it always comes back to that.
Yeah. It always comes back to the Ant-Man Thanos debate of 2017.
Dude, I think that they really just heard that meme. They're like, yeah, we can put that in season three.
Yeah.
Oh, that's definitely what that was.
Yeah.
It's fucking awesome.
Ooh, okay. Who could take out a grizzly bear?
Most people, honestly.
I don't think that's true.
Dude, you would die.
With that attitude, but I have a survivor's attitude.
Okay, I'm going to go with Tuba because he's built different.
Tuba.
True.
Yeah.
Yeah. Tuba is, in fact, built different.
Yeah. All right, that's my pick. Will? And then Skylar, you're gonna be up for two.
I'm gonna go with that. Hold on.
I want Coach Beard from Ted Lasso.
What's his name?
I want to watch Ted Lasso.
I heard
it's really good.
It is really good. You'd like it. What? Give us some clue. We can help you.
Who's that? No. It's gonna sound stupid if I say that. Yeah.
Come on.
I'm going with what's his name? The guy who's
You have to
a,
give
he's
us
a, he's, a comi- he's a comedian.
Bill Burr.
No.
Shut don't do this.
No, the comedian's bodyguard who beat that dude the fuck up.
Dave Chappelle's bodyguard?
Dave Chappelle's bodyguard?
I don't know why I'm drawing a blank on Dave Chappelle. Thank you. Yeah, Dave Chappelle's bodyguard. That's
all
what
right.
I'm picking.
He did beat the fuck out of that guy.
I think that is a fantastic
pick.
Yeah,
thank
you
very
much. Yeah, I appreciate that. I thought so.
All right, Sky for two.
Oh, I thought you were picking this. So I was going to pick Burt Kreisner. I think that he could fucking tear a grizzly bear apart.
Just all-time bad pick.
Yeah.
Brent Crystals would not do anything.
That was very funny.
He would get his ass handed to him by a grizzly.
He literally has a skit about getting his ass handed to him by a bear.
Boom.
A bear almost had sex with him.
Bern Krishna would have no chance against a bear.
I don't know. But he did.
Yeah, he lost. It's on record. Not many people
but,
on.
But
yeah,
he's
on record 0-1 with a bear.
But he's alive, no?
He is.
You don't have to die to lose.
Oh, I can't wait for my next pick.
I feel like you would have to.
No.
0-1 record with a bear.
If I ever came face to face with a bear and I came out alive, regardless of anything happened, I went.
No, you don't.
No, you're missing a crucial part of the story.
He let you live.
Fucking awesome.
No, I don't think. Regardless. All right,
your second pick.
Elsa.
That's so funny. I can't stop laughing about
what?
That. What we were just talking.
I think it would be funny though. I know the story, but
Bubble Buddy.
Sure. I would say I'm so sorry.
Just pick anyone. Think of a person.
Michelin Man.
Sure.
Okay.
Yep.
Is it my turn?
It is Will's turn.
I'm going with Thanos.
That's a good pick.
That's a good pick. Thanos would definitely beat him.
He beat the fuck out of him.
I'm going to go with DaBaby. It's my turn. And I'm taking DaBaby. DaBaby would murder him in a Walmart.
But he doesn't like our people.
DaBaby?
Yeah, he does. He's like,
is a grizzly bear a white gays. Is a grizzly bear a white cis man?
Absolutely.
Maybe. I don't know. Okay. Are you assuming
the grizzly bear's gender and orientation? Yes.
Yeah. That's fucked up.
No, I'm taking DaBaby. I think DaBaby would shoot that bear dead cold in a Walmart.
Point blank.
All right, Hunt, you're up. Point blank, yeah. Thank you, Will.
I'm going to take Leanne Kreischer.
I have a great pick I'm excited for.
Why? Because she already killed the bear?
She saved Bert from the bear.
All right, fair. All right. Ramon, for your final two.
My first, Tony Danza. Because I feel like behind all of that smiling, he can kill anybody.
Okay. It's a good pick.
And my second one, which I didn't think about nearly as much, but whatever. Angelina Jolie.
She could fuck up a bear.
Yeah.
Yeah, I feel that.
She'd be tough.
I like that. She got DSLs.
All right, Hunter here.
I'm going to take He-Man. No, I'm going to take Captain Planet.
Okay. It's a really good pick.
Captain Planet.
I'm going to take Bumblebee Man from The Simpsons.
Weird pick, but okay.
Thank you. I think in the costume, I think the bear would get he would take some swipes, think he won because he got costume, and then Bumblebee Man wouldn't actually be hurt. It would just be the costume, and then he'd land a shot.
From what I remember from his show on The Simpsons, I think that makes a lot of sense because it was a lot of like stunt comedy.
Thank you.
Did you just deep throat your mic?
Yeah, I was trying to get it going. My shit's been weird lately.
Kind of weird. You're a weird dude.
Thanks. You're up, Will.
All right, I'm not going to change it. I'm going with Alec Baldwin.
Why? Tell me why.
Specifically on the set of a movie.
Yeah, I mean, say he goes the route of, hey, I got this movie. Do you want to star in this movie? And
he's like,
and the bear's like, yeah, absolutely. I've been waiting for this. And then he brings the bear in, and he's like, hey, all right, cool. We're gonna shoot this movie, and he shot this movie. And that's all I'm gonna say.
And then he shot.
And he
the
also
bear.
Shot the bear.
He shot that motherfucking bear.
Oh,
William.
I went down the wrong road.
I thought it was great.
Thank you.
I mean, the logic tracks.
It does. It definitely
yeah,
tracks.
It's definitely a good pick.
I mean, like twice in one lifetime, Alec Baldwin.
Wait, he did that two times.
Yeah. Do you know him? Ooh. I have an honorable mention. Skyler, go ahead. Wrap this up.
Voldemort
would be good. I'm going to take Tony Stewart.
That's a good
one. I don't get that.
Tony Stewart killed a guy.
Yeah.
Did he?
Yeah.
Who? What?
Driving. Not a lot of people know that Tony Stewart killed a guy, but he did.
I don't know.
Shout out to the number 20 Home Depot car.
Wait, is he the one who said bad words and got kicked out of the...
I don't think so. He's the guy who murdered a man and,
you know,
and continued racing a NASCAR.
Another honorable
That's
mention.
Insane.
I'm going to say Obi-Wan.
Yeah. I think, once again, I think you're just taking so many
Star
better
Wars characters.
So many better people with the Force.
Well, Obi-Wan.
Like almost indefinite amounts of people better with the Force.
Well, I took Grogu. I think he would hold the stance against
just
the bear.
Grogu does not know the Force.
Yeah,
Grogu saved the Mandalorian like twice. Not spoilers.
Maybe Darth Vader.
You can
like
spoil
Darth
it,
Vader?
Dude. It's fine. Yeah, Darth Vader would have been an excellent pick.
Nah,
Anakin would have also.
Obi-Wan.
He could have killed baby bears.
They're kind of the one and the same.
Some would say, yeah. Me being one of the some.
Anakin,
yeah.
Yeah, maybe.
Specifically Anakin for baby bears, though.
Yeah.
Am I not wrong?
What?
I mean...
Cubs?
Cubs, yeah.
Yeah, he does ruin cubs. Dude loves killing cubs. I thought you were making an Ewok joke, but I'm learning that you're making a Padawan joke. My apologies.
Yeah, thank you. There we go.
Anyone can kill Ewoks.
Why don't you tell us more about that?
Not everybody can kill kids.
I mean, okay, it's almost time for our favorite new segment. Hunter texts Will two movies. I'm going to text Will two movies. I assume Will has at least two movies at the ready.
I kind of didn't.
I think that you're overestimating.
Dude, this was your favorite thing forever. So
I have two movies.
Okay. I'm going to text you two movies.
I have two movies.
All right, Ramon, this is our new most favorite segment called Will's Movies, Concussed. Will came on the show probably a month ago now.
Heavily concussed.
Incredibly concussed. Like, should not have driven level concussed.
I saw this video. I had no idea what was happening. I think I commented that too.
You did.
I have a fantastic movie to start this off, if you guys are ready.
Yeah, okay,
I'm ready.
I
sent you my movies.
This is a group one?
This is a group one. All right,
so, Ramon, the point of this game, Will's going to try to explain a movie almost like Pictionary style. Like, he can't use the name. It's not at all Pictionary style. My apologies.
No, what kind of?
He can't charades. No, not charades. It is Pictionary. I don't know. He can't use the name or any characters. He just has to explain it via plot.
Yep.
And describing characters.
Yes.
Yeah. And now we are entering Will's Concussed Movies.
No, it's Will's Movies, comma Concussed.
Will's Movies, comma Concussed.
Yeah, because it's your middle name at WMC. That when we made this, you were too concussed to call out.
WM
comma
C.
Middle name is John.
That M is not your middle name.
Not even close, but we're out here.
For the longest time, though, I thought it was also Michael.
We made this segment, Will's Movies Concussed, because you were like, just like my initials.
Is that what I said?
Yeah, just to not, in the end, be like, hey, my middle initial's not M.
It's J.
Will bamboozled himself.
Okay, ready? You guys ready?
Yeah.
I have two movies, so I'm going to do two, and then you guys can go ahead and do whatever, because we'll see if you can get it. But it depends how long it goes. Are you ready?
What? Yes.
3, 2, 1. Let's get heavily concussed.
Okay. All right.
So we got this. We got this. We got this. We're going to start it off.
Okay.
It's a nice, nice family here. It's a nice family. And in this family, there's something going on between all of them. But one of them doesn't know about it.
Stranger Things season 3.
This is a movie.
Okay.
Is it Us?
Nope. And in this, one of them doesn't know anything about it. And the other two know.
Oh, it's We're the Millers.
And they can't talk about it. However, one of the main characters is starting off in a new place with a bunch of new people that he can relate to.
What?
And the people that he can relate to, he doesn't realize that yet.
The Purge?
I like that guy's song. That's funny.
What's the pajamas Nazi movie?
No.
The Boy in Striped Pajamas?
And this, okay, so I'm going to add a little bit
Is
more.
Is it not We Are the Millers?
Nope. He has friends that he meets here, and he has one that he already knew when he was going there. And when he meets them, he already knows who they are, and he can relate to them on that level. He can relate to them. And also, the people that he meets, he can relate to, and they're all different people, but they're like the same kind of people that he can be friends with.
Is it Inside Out?
Nope.
Is it animated?
Nope, it's not animated.
Okay.
And
is it X-Men?
So there's a conflict. Nope. There's a conflict in this movie, and the conflict in the movie involves a guy, the main character that I was just talking about, that ends up falling for somebody. He falls for a chick. that also he can relate to.
What do you mean relate to? What does this mean?
That means that they both do the same thing. They have a hobby that is same, that is the same.
And, that's so not helpful.
And he has his friend group, right? And he starts drifting away from his friend group and seeing this chick more. And in that causes a conflict.
Is it
Is
love
it 500
you, man?
Days because, of summer?
Nope. But she,
is it I love you, man?
Nope. She is using him. She is using him for something that he doesn't understand at first because he's head over heels for this chick. But his friends realize it and they're trying to tell him. But he's like, what? What are you talking about? And his parents are a big factor in this because they're these big hashtag relatable people that I'm trying to talk about here that are really like the significant like role models in this movie.
Is it Father of the Year?
It is not. And this is a very family movie that involves, okay, the thing that I can relate to is they go to a school.
Well, all of us.
Not the parents, but they the parents used to go to the school.
Is it Little Rascals?
Nope.
And Sky High?
Oh my God, you got it. You got it.
I thought that so long ago.
You got it. You got it, dude. Oh my God.
What?
That's awesome.
How did you get that?
Once he said this, they used to go to the school, that's what I went with.
Oh, getting it done over here.
That flashed through my head like, at the beginning of this, and then I was like, no, he wouldn't be doing that. Wait, that I asked you if
no,
it was
listen,
a Disney movie.
Listen,
that,
all,
when I asked if it was a Disney movie, that
all movies.
Sky
all,
High is
yes
a
it
Disney
is
movie.
Yeah, it's absolutely.
That's why I asked.
Oh, I didn't.
Because I was gonna
movie
say Sky High, and then
oh,
when
I
you said
all,
no, I was like, oh.
All movies are on the table for Will's movies. All right, because
since you got
hey,
it, you guys
do,
go ahead.
Do my first one.
Oh, you texted it to me?
I texted you my, yeah.
This is a fun game here.
Thanks.
This is literally my favorite segment.
Hunter, I'll have to choose one of those.
Will, do you know either of the two movies I sent
yes
you? Do you know both of them?
100% do.
Do you know both of them?
Not the second one.
Fuck. All right. We're, if we have time, we'll.
I'm
okay.
I'm going to do the first one.
Okay.
Okay, so in this movie here.
All right, ready? 3, 2, 1, go.
Let's get concussed. In this movie, we have a... It's more of like a family movie. It's a family type movie, and it's a competitive. It's more of like a competition, and in this, involves training, and and there's a conflict in the family because there's jealousy, and one of the main characters.
You guys are never getting it
one
already.
One of the main characters in the movie doesn't really know how to communicate well. He doesn't. And it's not his fault. But it's a family movie, and he's a very competitive, you know, he's competitive. And the family wants him to be competitive because he's really good at what he does.
Literally anything else.
Is it The Incredibles?
And a lot of times, nope.
I also thought.
And a lot of times,
you and I also because of Dash, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, I thought the same.
And a lot of times, they think that they can't do it.
Well, buddy, I think you need to back up from the main plot and give them a generalization of the general movie.
What do you mean?
You're going too deep in. I think you need to basic it up on this one.
Okay, maybe a little bit more.
The details are not going to help on this movie.
He's not a qualified candidate to be competitive. He's not. They are not, I should say. They're not. They don't know really. They were never somebody that should have been
good.
How
many of them are there?
There's one.
What?
Oh, wait.
Free Willy.
I've seen this as a kid.
He doesn't know this movie.
Are you sure you're talking about the plural version or the singular version?
The Goonies.
The singular version.
Oh. All right. Then, yeah, carry on. I sent you a different movie. I sent you, like, the 9th sequel to this movie.
Oh. I'm talking about one of the originals.
Okay.
Okay, ready? I'll make it a little bit more interesting. So, he scores a lot
yep
because the type of of, you know, who he is or who they
the
are.
The player he is, really.
The player he is. Yeah. And when he scores a lot, his family is really proud of him.
Movie?
Is it Air Bud?
Oh, damn it.
Yes! Oh, that's what I meant.
So the thing was.
I don't know movies.
It's not Air Bud.
Oh. Damn it. Okay.
It's not Air Bud at all.
What was it?
It's Air Buddies.
Okay.
Oh,
okay.
I haven't seen Air Buddies.
The puppy sequel to Air Bud.
Okay.
But Will started explaining Air Bud.
My God.
All right.
Okay. Well, there's some movies I haven't seen.
Yeah, we know
I'm
that.
I'm so excited for Will to do mine.
I'm gonna do the second one, Hunt.
Okay. Okay. Have you seen that one?
Yeah. Oh yeah.
I'm gonna have
it. Saw it in theaters. Saw it in theaters.
That's a ludicrous statement.
Oh my God, this is great. I can't wait to do this. All right, I'm gonna think real hard about this. Let's get concussed.
Stop breathing into the
There was a lot. So in this movie, there's a very loud, impactful statement that happens. And
Dark Knight Rises.
No. And in this movie, it's a competitive movie.
What? Stop saying that.
And in the movie, involves a guy who's he's trying to make some money. You know, and
for a second, I didn't know if you knew the movie, I know for sure.
I'm trying to dumb
movie.
It down, dude. I got to dumb it down a little bit. You know, I don't want them to figure it out. But I might have actually, I'm not trying to spoil it, but I might have seen this with Riley, which is hilarious. in this movie, he's trying to make some money for his family. And
it's not his family.
It's not his family. What do you mean?
School of Rock.
Yes, no, it is.
It's not his family.
It's a thing that he really likes to do, though.
Okay, looking for drama.
No, it's something that the
text me
people...
two new movies, then.
Huh?
What?
You picked a movie.
No, you got to keep going.
All right, I'll keep going on it, then. All right, okay, I'll keep going on it, what I think it is. I've seen this movie. It's been a while, but I've seen this movie. It involves a lot of competition and the process of the competition, he's doing a lot of preparing for it. And when it comes to the main event, he is very
Eddie's Million Dollar Cook-Off.
Nope.
Dang it.
He is very much trying to be ready to win this thing. And
the Wizards of Waverly Place
He has a lot of confidence issues. And
is it a singing movie?
No, it is not a singing movie. I'm trying to
I don't know what the name is. The only one that comes to my mind is the movie that Jack Black did.
School of Rock.
When he was the Mexican wrestler.
Nacho Libre.
Yes.
It's not Nacho Libre.
Okay. Okay.
All right, Will, keep going.
This is a very well-known actor.
Okay.
That decides to go back to something that he used to do a long time ago because he was really good at it, and the people that his wife
she hates
not married
his wife is somebody that we know and has been in a lot of movies of this person that he's been in movies with is in and is encouraging him to do this thing that
uncut
he used
gems?
To do in high school. No,
I
it's
thought
not.
Uncut.
No, it is not. And basically,
do I get to participate since he's not doing my movie?
No.
Yes, I am.
Wait,
Hunt.
Yeah, he is.
Yes, I am, Hunt.
No, you're not. It's
Hunt,
not.
Have you
the same
seen
movie.
This movie?
I'm gonna listen to
Hunt.
Will.
Have you
hey,
seen
Will,
this movie?
Will, you keep going. You're doing
Hunt,
great.
No, wait, have you seen this movie though?
Yes.
I even fact checked it right
hey,
now.
Will?
Will,
you're doing great. Keep going.
Okay.
Is it Jason Bateman?
No, it is not.
Okay.
He has a
feels like a Jason Bateman.
He has a he has a signature thing that he comes out to. And it's
Is it a baseball movie?
And it's something that really helps him when he comes out. And at this
Is it Dodgeball?
Hunt, text me something if I'm off right now.
He has a is it a sport
Are you
movie?
Talking about the actor specifically or the movie?
The movie.
The movie. And
is it a sport movie of any sort?
Yeah.
I texted you the main character, like the main actor.
Is it Goon?
It's not Goon. That's a great movie, though.
Okay.
He does a great job at improving and getting to the final.
Mighty Ducks?
No, but you guys are right on. And like I said, he's an actor that we know.
What's a hockey?
And that we've seen.
Is it a basketball movie?
Hon, text me something here.
Is it a hockey movie?
No, it is not.
Is it a basketball movie?
It is not a basketball.
Is it one of the big four?
It is not.
Hold on.
Is it kicking and screaming?
No, but okay. But what happens a lot in this movie is he has to overcome his own personalities here.
That's like every sport movie.
Oh my God, I forgot about that.
Let's hear it.
Okay, so he's also trying to, he wants money for what he's doing. Yep. Of course, everybody wants money, right?
Is the main
not
actor,
for his family.
Is the main not, actor Will Ferrell?
It's not Will Ferrell, but he's trying to raise some money because he's trying to get in the pants.
Is it The Ringer with Johnny Knoxville?
He's trying to raise money and show that he's tough.
Oh,
for
oh,
not his wife,
fuck,
but a chick because he's like, hey, I can do this. Watch me. And he's raising all this fucking money, and he's doing a great job at it. But also,
okay, now I think we'll see the movie.
Happy Gilmore.
No.
Nope. But you are so fucking on, Riley. It's insane.
Is it Adam Sandler?
It's not Adam Sandler.
It's not Adam Sandler. But I'll tell you, he comes out to this every time. It's something he comes out to, and it gets him hyped before he does this. And it is an actor that the person that you just said might kind of know a little bit.
Rob Schneider?
You're
not Rob Schneider.
Fucking hot, man.
It is. It's Kevin James. We need. Here comes the boom.
Boom.
Yeah.
Let's go.
Here comes the boom. Here comes the boom.
I actually never saw that movie.
Y'all
I
really
want that.
It now.
Oh, my God. When Will was like, he's raising money for his family, I was like, well.
He's raising money for the chorus program of a school.
And that
the
is
band.
That's some Will's heavily concussed
Listen,
movies.
Listen, I'd raise money for Selma Hayek too.
Again. Oh,
I also
oh
would
God,
raise
I would
money
too,
for Selma
man.
Hayek.
Gorge. Gorgeous.
As soon as you said it's all right, Will, I want you to try and do my second movie.
Oh my God, are you serious?
Yes.
All right, I'll do a quick recap of this. Say.
You're gonna look
it
up. You're gonna look up.
I'm not even gonna look it up.
Good. That's what we want here.
I don't
that's
even know what this
on.
Is. Let me look at it one more time. Okay. All right.
All right.
Here
we go. Let's get concussed.
Let's get concussed. Now, he's pretty important. Whatever this thing is, it's important, and they're valued to a level that they should be. Because they were chosen to do.
This is a sport this. Movie.
And it's a sport movie, yes.
About hockey.
The Mighty Ducks.
Whatever they did right earned them this position, and that's why they're doing it.
Is it Miracle?
It's not, but I don't know if you're close.
that's an all-time quote.
I'm going to say monkeypox might have something to do with this. Riley might think that's funny. I don't know.
It's good. It's
I
good.
Hope it's Cool Runnings.
It's not.
They were chosen to do this thing.
I'm gonna explain the plot of this movie when Will's done.
I think that they had to do with. I don't know. Go ahead.
No, you continue.
That they're not gonna die or nothing because they're held to this standard, and they're supposed to be doing what they need to be doing because if they die, they're not.
All right, you want me to take over?
Yeah, please.
All right, so there's this monkey, right?
Curious George.
I was close.
No.
With the monkey pops. All
right, so there's this monkey, right? And he is
it MVP?
It is MVP.
This guy
most valuable primate.
This guy did it.
The moment.
Dude, you're 2 for 2 over there, bro.
The moment.
All All right, so Will, MVP Most Valuable Primate. You got to watch it. It's a hit. So this movie.
It's a hit.
There's this monkey, right? This chimp, the chimpanzee. He's an actor, and he escapes the grips of his acting people because they're making him a bad life. And he ends up landing in the bath. He climbs through the bathroom of this, like, Minnesotan family. Okay, and the family's like, oh, no, a monkey. They don't know what to do with him. And he's, like, out by the pond. He's watching the kid in the house who's he just snuck into get bullied. Yeah. And then he goes out and he slaps a slap shot and he fucking top cheddars it. Top and they're like, damn, this monkey can play hockey. So then the monkey starts playing hockey and becomes a hockey MVP.
So kind of like Air Bud.
Yeah, it's Air Bud, but with a chimpanzee who plays
can
hockey.
I just say?
Unbelievable.
That the 90s had...
What a wild time for animal Disney movies.
Like, for real.
I know, because there was also that Shaggy Dog movie.
Beethoven, like 1-7?
Yeah.
Yeah, with Tim Allen.
Never mind. That's a conversation
Dunstan
for
checks
another day.
In.
All once, the Air Buds.
Once the producers figured out, oh, kids like animals, they just... through every animal they could find.
Hey guys, question. If you had to choose any animal that was probably transgender, which one do you think it would be?
Excuse me?
It's not the question.
No,
I can't even comprehend that question.
No, that is the question, and we're here to answer it.
Do you want to know my answer?
Is it chimpanzees?
It's a zebra.
Why? Go ahead.
Because he's got stripes.
What is stripes lingo for something? Or you just think stripes mean like he swings?
You know, I realized that I was
going
to make
keep going.
Nah, I was going to make a straight joke, but I realized it's a stripe joke.
What?
I hated everything about that.
Will, what does that mean?
Happy Pride Month. That's all that meant.
I hated everything about that. I don't know. I don't even know what happened.
What animals do you guys think are probably
I was going to say like some type of lizard because I know that, you know, that's the thing. I don't know the exact lizard exactly because I'm not like, you know, a biologist. I was going to say lizards.
Seahorses.
Oh,
seahorses. Yeah. Okay. Yeah. 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 Okay.
See, well,
I like
seahorses.
That there was an answer to it. And it's
yeah.
Seahorses.
Are they asexual?
No. The male just carries the baby. So it's like.
Oh, hell yeah, dude. Dudes
both
are getting
sides.
Loads dumped into them. That's what's up, dude.
That's.
Hell
nope.
Yeah.
No.
Yeah, dude.
No,
getting...
the female makes the baby, but the man carries it around.
They transfer
it. I got one.
Yeah.
It's not an animal, but so, a butterfly.
I want you to explain more on that.
Do they
statement.
Have genders?
Because they transition. Into a caterpillar.
See, if that had
okay,
been the first
okay,
joke,
okay, okay, okay,
I would have. There would have been
you.
Much better.
Yeah,
his mic is
I
off
agree.
Now. He's lost.
As
mic.
It should be.
He's lost mic privileges.
That's crazy.
That is the best joke I've ever heard.
Oh. God, I wish that was the first one. Oh.
That's. Oh, man. All right, I'm turning you back on. You said when you came in here you had some crazy stuff to talk about. Please, that wasn't it, right?
No, that wasn't it.
All right.
It was just something silly that I said yesterday. I said we're living in the era of big butts and competitive chicken sandwiches.
We are living in the age of competitive Ooh. Chicken sandwiches. I don't disagree
Pretty
with that.
Pretty sick age to live in,
and I
by
have
the way.
Some feedback. I got a Jack Harlow meal.
Good?
I hated myself for it.
Sure.
And KFC.
You had to go to wherever it was and go, I'd like one Jack Harlow.
No, no,
meal.
No. No, see, the thing was, I tried.
You
to...
ask for a Travis Scott burger?
I tried to not. I was like, can I get a spicy chicken sandwich with a side, with the fries meal and a side? And they're like, oh, the Jack Harlow meal? And I was like, no. I'd like a chicken sandwich with fries and a side.
Please don't make me agree to this.
Yeah, like, please.
Just type it in and
I'll pay like $3 extra if it like if you have to ring it up different. I will pay the extra money for it to be ringed up different. I don't care. Like, Please just do not put Jack Harlow meal on my fucking screen or receipt.
Don't put that on
my
me.
My receipt says Jack Harlow meal.
I think that
I'll
might be the name of this episode is the Jack Harlow meal.
You don't want it to be transitioning butterflies?
Relatable.
KFC, garbage chicken sandwich. They entered the chicken sandwich game late, and they're not good.
So did Panera.
They're not.
Panera has a chicken sandwich?
Yeah, that's what made me realize.
Like a fried chicken sandwich?
Yes, dude.
I mean, like, it's a two-legged race with Chick-fil-A and Popeyes, right? Like,
Popeyes, yeah.
Popeyes is pretty good.
Popeyes is great, but
I think Chick-fil-A is overrated.
I think Chick-fil-A is super overrated. And you know what? Well, as a gay podcast, we don't stand with them.
That's right.
We're gay as hell, dude.
Yeah, Boston denied a Chick-fil-A. Fuck out of here.
Yeah, that's
you guys know that?
Yeah, they.
That seems like bad business.
No, Chick-fil-A wanted to open a restaurant in like the Quincy market of.
Yeah.
And they were like, we will not have this restaurant here because we do not stand with people who.
Yeah, because Chick-fil-A does not support the gays because they're super religious.
I think that was bad business by Boston.
You know what I say?
I think they should have put a Chick-fil-A in.
You know what I say? Shout out the Fonz. That's the only religion that matters.
The Church
what?
Of the Fonz. The Church of the Fonz.
Dude, I don't understand how your brain works.
You don't listen to Plungeons and Dragons, it's clear.
Huh, what do you mean, bro?
You showed your hand.
Yeah, dude, I don't even listen to The Plunge.
That's true.
Who are you?
What? Did I tell you about the Joe Biden guy? Did I say that on last
Did anybody podcast? See Joe Biden fell off his
did
bike?
Did you? I have it at the ready, don't worry. If you didn't, Ramon, you didn't. It's the best video the internet's had in years. Joe Biden.
Oh,
was,
wait. The one that happened like a couple of months ago?
No, it happened this morning. Old Joe fell again.
Oh, then no.
All right, he fell again, and it's one of the funniest videos I've ever fucking seen. Here we go. I just recorded it. Everything's good, right, Joe
Hook
Biden?
Got caught.
He just pumped the brakes. There's only 2 seconds left in the video. What can go wrong, right? And fucking down goes Joe.
How did that happen?
Amazing.
It's the best video.
It's like he forgot what side he was trying to get off on.
Dude, he just forgot he was on a bike.
Oh, do you know what happened?
His foot got caught in the pedal.
Yeah, his foot stuck. Look.
He has little foot holsters on his little...
Yeah, right here. His foot got caught in it.
Oh. It did get caught.
It's so funny. Fucking
dude,
old.
He's like
I gotta say,
a thousand years old. He should not be riding a bike.
He kind of looks great.
That's also true.
He kind of looks great, though.
No.
Yeah.
He's old.
He looks in shape, dude. My grandma couldn't ride a fucking bike. Dude, it's just the best.
Listen, I'm all for, because there were plenty of old people that like work out. But I know it's not Joe, because he's too busy. Doing whatever he
does.
We'll
get
I don't
to
know.
That because Working you're out. You're pursuing the presidency.
And I have no idea what they do.
That's true. I popped into your live the other day and someone was like, what does the president do if you're running for president? And you're like, I don't fucking know. I have no idea.
Like, yeah, exactly.
You're like, I'm gonna run, but I don't know what it entails.
You
Will, did you know
clue.
Ramon's running for president?
I'd vote.
I didn't even need to tell. All right, yeah, word. All right, that's
Thank
that.
Thank you.
Absolutely, it's better than what we got going right now.
Ramon,
that's what everyone.
I was shocked. Yeah. Someone in the chat was like, "You have to be old enough," and you're like, "I'm over 35." You're over 35?
Yeah, I'm 35. Yeah, my birthday was in March.
That's what's up. I think last time we talked, you weren't quite there yet, and that's why I was surprised. Because now
you're officially
on
going to be the president.
Yes.
I mean, there's a lot of stuff before then.
That you don't know about, clearly, from that TikTok live.
Yes, that's completely true.
I popped in there like, how are you going to start? And you're like, I don't know. I'll figure it out.
Like, that's not an out question.
What party are you running under?
Oh, okay. So.
All right, let's hear it.
Okay, here's the thing. The last time you guys asked me about this, like any of this, I had like no idea what I was doing. Now, admittedly, I still don't have any idea what I'm doing.
But
I have made a lot of stuff up on my end.
Okay.
I'm all in.
So what I'm going to do,
I know you're going to tell us, but we're already in, so this is just gravy. Go on.
Sure. So first, I'm going to run a writing campaign, because you have to fill out a bunch of forms and stuff
to be on the ballot.
Yeah, okay. None of which I want to do. Fair. You also have to pay money, which, again, since they can all go suck off, I don't want to do. So,
can we make you a write-in campaign, like, front-lawn sign?
I mean,
I would put that, when 2024 election comes around, I will put a write-in Ramon sign on my front yard.
What would be the first thing you would do as president?
Well, no, we got to hear about his new ideas and his new things that are coming.
His platform.
So, yeah, his platform.
So my platform, like, because people ask me that all the time, it's like, I don't know. But what I tell people, my platform is pretty simple. It's fuck the police, fuck the government, and clean up the environment.
Okay,
that's
pretty much it.
That's what's up.
I can get behind that, like the kids say.
My first thing I would do, I don't know. There's a lot of stuff that I want to do. Like, I want to kick Jeff Bezos in the dick. But I don't know if that's the first thing I'll be able to do.
You should befriend him and, like, become his best
friend. I almost
friend
lost my drink. That was bad.
Kick him in the balls.
I mean, that's also an option. Like, I don't know the first thing I want to do is. Because I feel like that's too much pressure. I'm literally just going at this one step at a time and making it up. We'll see what happens.
Dude, I could just say.
Oh, another thing that I said the first thing I want to do is I want to paint the Oval Office like completely black and like just paint it into a bunch of neon colors and set up like a rave room.
Okay.
It's like an old school roller rink.
Yeah, exactly like that.
That'd be so sick.
That's what I'm saying.
I like it. I really do like that.
Ramon, can I recommend something?
Sure, go ahead.
All right, so Obama did this, and that's why everyone thinks he's cool as hell, but he did a bunch of things that were cool as hell. One of them being Barackatology. He would make a March Madness bracket and call it Barackatology. And I just saw that, and I was like, Obama's cool as hell.
I remember that.
I didn't know that was a thing.
If you just do things that people are like, Ramon's cool as hell.
I didn't know that was a thing. But that being said, since I objectively don't want to be cool, I just want to be a menace to all these people.
Okay.
I am probably going to start like a D&D club.
Okay.
Can I
recommend something then if you're trying to be a menace?
Sure.
Anytime rabbits are coming into the country, you should eat them and continue the famine.
When you told me that, I was like,
that sounds pretty cool. Like,
added it to the notebook.
Yeah, exactly.
He's like, huh, kidnap directors and actresses.
So here's the thing. Like, lots of people ask me to do, like, actual stuff. And I write it down because, you know, I'm also, like, helping people. I want to help people, especially if it comes at the chance of me screwing over all the rich people.
Okay.
Okay.
But the reason why I don't say that stuff is because it's not, like, it's not directly connected to me. There's not like stuff that I intentionally want to do. I don't like telling people, oh, I'm definitely going to do this. I'm definitely going to get rid of student loan debt, or I'm definitely going to fix the environment or the, any of this stuff, anything, just literally anything, everything happening right now. But I don't say it because I feel like if I do stuff like that, then I'm just objectively lying to people. Like every other politician. So I don't. I just tell people I don't know what the hell I'm actually going to do or talking about. Or you should vote for me.
We would get what you said you were going to do. Because if you don't know, like, we're gambling.
Yeah.
Exactly. That's exactly the point. Because it's a gamble no matter what. Because if the people who tell you stuff that they're so-called actually going to do, you don't know if they're actually going to do it. I keep bringing up like the same example. Running for president is like going in for a job and saying, I'll definitely do this job better than you want me to. And then they go in and they punch a hole through the computer and said, listen, I know I destroyed the main system, but if you fire me and hire that other guy, he's going to set this whole building on fire. And you don't want that. You should just keep me here.
Yeah, I might just keep punching holes in computers, but
better if you than keep that me guy around. Burning
the building down.
Yeah, exactly. It's like that's dumb.
Ramon, who's your who's been your favorite president in U.S. history?
I don't know. Like, if I had to,
I can tell
one...
you, mine's Andrew Jackson. That dude was sick.
Yeah, he was pretty dope. I'll probably have updates on U.S. presidents at some point in this season with our history podcast. But
I like that. I really like this history
I'm
segment.
So excited.
Because U.S. history, I got to say, the tyrants are big old knuckleheads, but so are some of the U.S. presidents. Mm-hmm. Big knuckleheads.
Oh, absolutely.
Yo, Ulysses S. Grant, man, that guy was fucking dope.
Yeah, yeah, totally.
Do you know who my favorite figure in U.S. Let's all go around and give our favorite figure in U.S. history.
I'm just going to steal it. I'm going to say John F. Kennedy regardless. I don't know.
Why?
Because he was probably one of the better humanitarian presidents. He really cared about the people in the country having the ability to...
He did a really good job of making you think he thought that, which is commendable.
Okay.
My favorite... My favorite person is Cornelius Vanderbilt. That guy was a fucking baller.
Yeah, that guy was pretty baller.
He was Elon Musk and Jeff Bezos before it was cool to be that.
Yeah,
he was shutting down railroads because he felt like it. People did
him. He's like, oh, you didn't pay me my tax?
Dude, people did him wrong.
You can't travel anymore.
Dude,
yeah, I do know, yeah.
People did him wrong. So what he would do is be like, oh, you have 300 shares of my company? He owned so much of his company that he would just dilute the stock so their shares were worth like 10 cents. And he's like, oh, yeah, I just have 700 billion stocks now. Sorry. And just
kind of like a young Jordan Belfort, right? Like,
yeah, but it, with the money and like actual success of Jeff Bezos. Just a real
scumbag. He was insane.
Isn't that also the guy that... Again, I don't know if it's actually true. Supposedly, the Monopoly Man is based off
of? Yes, correct.
Yeah, yeah.
He owned New York. Like, the Rockefellers and shit had to go through him. He was the fucking man.
Love it.
If you're at home right now and you're like, I've never heard much about Cornelius Vanderbilt, do some research. Guy's a real knucklehead.
Number one history podcast that you have to do your homework for.
Just talking about.
Oh, no, I'm just talking about in history, just U.S. history.
No, I thought we were just talking
about... I don't have a favorite president. They all stink.
My favorite history person would be Nikola Tesla.
Yeah? The man who just could not get his hand... Well, he didn't put in patents, right? Like, that was his thing.
No, yeah. Yeah, because he wanted everything to be like...
public use.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Then Ben Franklin was like, yeah, I'll be taking these.
Yeah, even intellectual property.
Yeah. And now he has a car named after him.
Oh, speaking of which, I don't know if I can actually do this, but I don't care.
Okay.
If I can figure out a way to, like, get rid of that, then I definitely will. Because I want to see the movies that people will make. If they don't have to worry about that stuff.
Have you seen the horror movie with the Winnie the Pooh horror movie?
I want to see that so badly.
Dude, like, we need more of that. We need
exactly.
We need Warner Bros. To go under and just have all of that be free reign.
Like, exactly.
I'll write the movie.
Yeah, all right.
Will. I would fucking love to see a movie directed by Will.
I agree. You guys want to rock out with our talks out?
I do, but I'm sad that the sandwich guy took a little bit of a break.
He's here.
Yeah.
He took a break, though. We are very caught up.
But he's
not on a break now.
I love him. Roll for sandwich.
Ramon, are you familiar with Roll for Sandwich guy? You're a TikTok guy. You're a...
I'm not. Okay. I mean, I am, but I'm not like... I don't know a lot about actual TikTok.
Okay.
I'm on like...
All right, we're going to end with Roll for Sandwich guy, so you'll see him.
He's fantastic.
Here's Peanut Butter Craig.
Coming to a
Friday.
I don't
like Peanut Butter Craig.
Peanut Butter Friday. Experience. Mother Nature in the woods. Yes, Peanut Butter Friday. Mother Nature. Can't get...
So this is Peanut Butter Craig. He fucks jars of peanut butter and then posts about it.
I like him.
Ah.
Yeah. Well, he calls them Peanut Butter Fridays when he gets his rocks off in a container of peanut butter.
Thanks, Greg.
And now coming soon is Peanut Butter Fridays in the woods, where he's going to fuck peanut butter jars outside.
Mm-hmm.
Yep. Pretty good.
That's not good at all. That's just not, that's
Hello
objectively
on this
not good.
Tuesday, June.
I don't know when our Florida guy got fucking triple D titties.
I wasn't sure what it looks like, I was looking at.
Dude,
his nipples are so hard.
Dude, he's got he's got cannons.
Cause I thought he had gone through like massive weight loss and like it was just all in his midsection. But no, that is what I'm looking at. Okay.
All of the comments, mommy, I whipped it out so fast.
Oh my god.
14th, 2022, it's almost 2 o'clock. It's 91 in my bag.
I mean, he's just got fucking cannons. I can't stop looking at him. I gotta
see, those are huge.
Why don't I like Greece? Well, let me tell you some reasons why I don't like the movie Greece. First of all, I'd start off by saying that most Greasers in the subculture don't like Greece. Most Greasers I know don't like that movie. So I feel the same way I feel about the movie.
I like that it's he speaks for all movie. Greasers.
He does. So this is Gavin the Greaser. He's a modern day Greaser.
who named him Gavin the Greaser?
Himself. he's a modern day Greaser, and he tells TikTok all about the Grease lifestyle and how it is to be a Grease.
I wouldn't listen to him.
Yeah, you're gonna right now.
I don't like
movie.
Gavin.
Not good at all. I'm gonna tell you why though.
Tell
I
us
like
why,
it.
Gavin
and why
I
the Greaser I know don't like the movie at all. Here's reasons why I don't
speaks
like it.
Kind of looks like Tuba.
Speaks for all Greasers.
It's like Tuba the Greaser.
Oh my god.
Reason one. It's got nothing to do with the subculture. Now, here's the thing. If you're wanting to watch, you know, a Greaser film that's, you know, more relatable to the subculture, don't watch Grease. Because it's not at all relatable. Okay? All this fucking dancing, you know.
Greases would never dance.
Every moment of second of day is not something we do. All right?
Greases don't dance.
Don't go around here, you know. Summer loving had me a blast. You know,
but he has seen it.
He has seen it, and he
knows
the songs. He just sang the song in tune.
That's why he has a list. He's watched it multiple times and made this list.
He's like, yeah, well, okay, one. Fuck it. We don't go after pretty ass bitches, okay?
Dude, hate drives people to do the most wild shit.
I see where your confusion comes in. He has a tuba neck beard.
Oh, that's what it is.
Yes.
No, his whole face. Come on.
All that stupid shit. We don't do that. We never did that.
Come get over it. Possibly.
Wait a second.
That's tuba.
Tell us, Ramon.
This argument doesn't even make sense because they didn't do it either. That's why they. That's why that was the problem.
Like, the Greasers in the movie didn't dance.
I'm not trying to defend Grease. What I'm just saying, like, that was the central conflict
of the film.
It, like,
that's a great movie.
That's a good point, dude.
I mean, I like Grease too.
Grease is one of my favorite movies.
I'm gonna concuss that movie next week. Stay tuned.
All right, so there's these guys and there's these ladies, right? And they have some conflict.
And then they don't dance.
And then they end up racing for some reason.
And then they fly off into the sun, even
also,
though there's no magic in this film.
I'm really going off on a tangent with this. Also, it's a musical. They're not actually like.
No
one's
dancing.
With the exception of, like, some parts, they're not actually dancing.
It's just the delivery of the lines. Like, they're not their real, like.
Like, I think it was, like, the actual dance competition.
Yeah.
And maybe at the end, at the carnival, if you look at it in a certain way. Like,
also,
I think
when they're singing right at the beginning, when they're talking about when they met in the summer, when
yeah,
they're
I'm gonna,
all
I'm gonna,
around,
right.
up and
hey,
down,
I'm gonna,
teachers, the whole thing is a musical.
Yeah, let me parlay off
everywhere.
Of, let me parlay off of your point, though. He thinks most Greasers don't do that. That's also the plot of the movie, because Danny does it in secret on summer vacation.
Exactly.
So, like, the friends you know that don't do it, maybe one of them does, and then bam,
that's
you have
right.
the movie
Yo,
grease.
Yo, Gavin the Greaser, you just got deceased. Sit down, brother. Sit down.
See, that's why you can't talk for all greasers.
You can't talk for all greasers, dude, because someone's
what
out there dancing.
Danny Zuko.
Yeah, Danny
Zuko. That's exactly why. This is exactly why. That's exactly why Danny had to do it in secret.
Yeah, exactly. Because guys like this, guys like Gavin the Greaser,
we just cracked
the toxic masculinity.
Yeah.
That's exactly what technically is toxic.
Grease a little up, chew up.
Yeah.
Toxic shoe up ability.
Grease is in the 50s into it. Modern day cats don't do it. We don't do it. It's not a thing we do.
Shut up.
Okay.
Homie, him writing
there are some
like, motor
things
that
I kind of like about Grease, but as far as the whole movie goes, it's just not good. It's not a good movie at all.
He doesn't like the music. He just said it. There were things he liked about the movie. It's the music. That's what he doesn't like. He doesn't like the singing.
Yeah, man. I just don't personally like it.
I bet he does like it, but he has to keep up image.
Oh, he is Danny Zuko. He's the Zook man.
Absolutely. He sings on his own. He has a separate account that he
has.
Like
this one is not good audio content, but boy, oh boy, is Evpap off the deep end. So FPAP's dancing in his pediatrician's office despite him being like 22 years old.
He's 22.
I got to go. I got to say it. I'm going to be honest with the people here. I've been bullying FPAP in the comments lately.
I mean, Riley, he has it coming.
Today he posted something and I just said, this is what happens when you stop bullying in America.
Oh, my God.
He's
Riley.
That's a bad image. You don't want that.
No, I do.
No, that's
just for him.
For him only.
Just for him. He asked. Hey. He posted a singing clip today. He said, honestly, give me an honest rating, guys. 1 to 10. I commented, soft one.
soft one.
Can we see this video?
Yeah, I can show you a singing video. My comment might be on it.
Yeah, you don't know. You
oh
don't
my
know
God.
Ev. You don't know Ev, don't do you?
Yeah, you don't know Evpap. You don't want to know Evpap.
Not like we do.
I gotta be honest. I think he deleted it.
Aww.
His comment or the video?
With how the engine sounds, we held darkness and withheld clouds. I will.
I can't.
The look on your face says it all.
See, you want to bully FPAP too. There we go. You see?
I don't want to bully you.
Oh, here we go.
Get this from 1 to 10 for me. Thank you very much.
I was thinking about who you are. Delicate point of view. I was thinking about you. Ooh.
To be fair, that's better than some of his videos.
It's soft.
Like, that's a strong performance
maybe
from him.
If he looked a
soft
little better,
one.
If it was the really shirt, maybe the look. Like,
in the whip on a Tuesday night with the music high and you're by myself.
He just can't dance
that's
and he
right
keeps
there.
Dancing.
That
he can't
is a
dance.
Great pause right there. That is
Riley,
no,
you should start
see,
remaking all of his videos.
Like, stitch them and just do his dances.
Yeah.
Oh.
I might start doing that with him, and I might start doing it with Timothy Robert Castles and revoicing his videos.
I don't like that.
Yeah.
Can we get them from Plunging for a Cause?
Hello, everybody. Welcome back to my videos on TikTok and Instagram. Timothy Robert Castles
here.
If
you're bullying somebody, they don't really want to be on your podcast.
Riley,
you
could take over his account.
Dude, I could take over Timothy Robert Castles.
That's how good you sound.
Oh, wait, that's Mike 525 Rocket.
I missed
him. Back?
No.
Are you stupid? Or you dumb? One of the two. You must be fucking stupid. Are you stupid or are you dumb? Must be one of the two. You must be fucking stupid. Because I am not 12.
Because I am not 12.
You listen here and you listen good, people.
You listen here and you listen good, people.
That was my best one.
Oh my God.
That is by far your best one.
You listen here and you listen good, people.
I love Timothy Robert
we
Castles
meet
so
him one
much,
day.
Dude. Ramon, can you go live with Timothy Robert Castles and get me in? I'm friends with him on Snapchat, but he's never answered me before.
Gee, I wonder why.
Yeah. Yeah, man, listen, TRC's, I got a fun video that Will's going to like a lot.
Play it one more time.
Did he ripped right through it?
He's a big guy.
Oh, my God.
Yeah.
Look at that wave.
That guy's a pure unit.
Did you see the wave he put?
Why would you pencil dive and think that would work?
Just one more time for the wave. One more time for the wave.
Did you hear him? He popped up and goes, 3 more weeks of winter.
Gotta die. 3 more weeks of winter.
That's the lead video.
What is this?
He's not nearly as the size of
what
a gopher.
What is this?
Well, I don't know who needs to hear this, but cheese meat fucks. Hallelujah.
What the?
Did he say cheese meat?
Cheese meat fucks.
Yeah, that's what he said.
Yeah, cheese
meat
fucks.
Cheese
meat
fucks.
That's the new thing.
This guy's videos make me laugh.
I like that, you know, he took the first one not expecting to make it.
I know.
But he was still going to post it.
He's getting better.
What is this house he lives on? I like it. I'm a fan.
What's up, Bean Groom? While we're on the subject of looking at new achievements and abilities based on non-scale of...
Will, you love Brantley G. What's up, Bean Crew? I'm a fan of the Bean Crew. Ramon, are you familiar with Brantley G and the Bean Crew?
I'm not, no.
Okay.
Oh, my God, dude.
He's the man.
What's up, Bean Groom? While we're on the subject of looking at new achievements and abilities based on non-scale objectives, I thought I'd mention...
You know, as you do.
Dude, he is the size of a refrigerator.
You didn't need to say that.
Yeah, no, but, like, I'm being serious. It's like he starred in Cars.
Well,
what?
Will, you can't say that about people.
Why?
Because it's not nice.
It's motivation.
It's not.
He starred in Cars. He does look like one of those Smartmobile. Like,
maybe Sully. Or maybe Sully from Monsters, Inc.
Yeah, that would be a nice...
This big old bag of dog poop. When I was like,
that might have to be a sound clip.
Look at this big old bag of dog food.
This big old bag of dog food. When I was like, before I was working out, I used to like need to, you know, throw it over my shoulder and carry it like this. And my dog doesn't eat much dog food. She only eats like a bowl a day, so I haven't really needed to replace it since before. I started working out. So
he's been working out. Yeah, he's showing you. He's showing you non-standard,
awesome.
Non-standard life objectives.
Awesome.
Come on, dude.
William, are you a piece of shit?
Well, this used to be super heavy.
Non-standard life objectives. Big as hell.
I could even throw it a bit. And it's easy. Yeah, like those guys in the weightlift competition.
This whole guy's a sound clip.
The ceiling's not high enough. You get it, right? It's like light now.
This makes me happy.
Is that his ka-chow? I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I really like Brantley.
I love him, dude, but like, holy shit.
Dude, I love Brantley.
He gets bigger every time I see him.
No, he gets smaller every time you see him. He's been working out, dude. He's been doing calisthenics. Okay. You don't know about his calisthenics. That's the non-objective objective right here. Is he used to? He's so strong now that the dog food's light for him when
I'm
it used to be heavy.
I really am.
Why? Again, that's totally what this is about, and good for him.
Yeah,
I'm really happy.
Brantley's the man. Don't you disrespect Brantley? I've said many mean things
doing.
About him,
I
but
really,
also I like him.
I respect.
He's
him.
One of those people that I'd be like, oh man, I'd love to get him on the show, and then he'd listen once to our history,
be
and
like,
be you,
like, yeah,
and be like,
no,
you were mean
good.
To me, and I'd be like, I didn't mean it though.
Just tell him. Just tell him I'll stay away.
Ramon's one of the very few that we've only ever said good things about.
Seriously?
From day one, we were like, we like this guy, and there's no other opinion we will have.
I want to be a part of the Bean Crew.
You are part of the Bean Crew if you stop fucking bullying him. All
right.
Like, Evpat, hey, take all your aggression towards Brantley G.
Towards Jeffrey.
And no, and put it towards Evpat. Just start ripping Evpat.
Don't redirect it. Especially not towards...
He's 19, all right?
Oh, my God.
All right.
19 is a fragile age. You can fuck somebody up at that age.
Yeah, apparently I am. Here's Nicole.
Yo, what's up, soda lovers?
Here's Nicole.
I love you. And today I'm reviewing Wild Eve Soda. This soda by Northwood Soda Co. is made with Northern Michigan apples and was bitten by ginger. And now...
Did you say beaten by ginger?
Bitten.
That's really so I heard too.
Oh.
It's a bite.
Oh, okay. He's beaten by ginger. This is guy Ginger. He beats the fuck out of apples for us.
As told by Ginger.
A carrot top.
That was a great show, by the way.
It was.
Wait.
This soda is not too good.
Oh, and that is a
one
two,
star.
No, one, two stars.
One.
Not very good is usually two stars.
One.
Okay is three. No. Is pretty good
bad.
Four?
This soda is bad.
No, bad is one star. He said not very good, which would be a two stars.
I think he's gonna hit us with a one star.
I think he's regiment as fuck. He's hitting us with two stars.
I'd give it a two stars.
Yeah.
It's like spicy apple cider, and I can definitely taste the ginger. And I don't recommend.
Why, that's so good.
It sounds pretty
that.
Good. I'm gonna be honest. The more I wanna
try it now.
The more he described it, the more I was like, "Well, this can't be a two, surely." But I trust him more than anyone in soda.
I do too. Immediately after not knowing him, but I think it might just be a personal taste thing.
That's fair.
100%.
He might just not like ginger apples.
It's fine.
Maybe if Mark beat them instead of Ginger, they'd be fine.
Man, he still loves track. Like and follow for more reviews from Nicole, comments from me. Try. Until next time.
Thanks. Ooh, he's got a new template for his outro.
Thanks, Nicole. I love him.
How old is he?
Bro, this guy, he keeps making these sandwiches. He keeps making the goat cheese and peanut butter sandwich and having other people make the peanut butter and goat cheese sandwich.
I need some consensus from Sandwich Talk. Sandwiches of History, Sandwich Dad. You guys.
I love that shit.
Sandwich TikTok. Assemble.
All right, so here's another popular
chosen a sandwich,
sandwich man.
For adventures in Ardia, and Destiny has chosen us to affirm its ranking as a 10 out of 10. Roll for sandwich dice have chosen Italian bread, peanut butter, goat's shiz, banana peppers, an alligator pear, iceberg lettuce, and kimchi mayo, which I don't have, so I just use sriracha mayo. Definitely not the same, but it is the same color. So here's our bread, our crunchy peanut butter, next the chèvre, next the alligator pear, and I'm going to throw some salt and pepper on there as a rule here at Sandwich Dad, next banana peppers, iceberg lettuce, and standing in for the kimchi mayo, the sriracha mayo.
Whoa.
Combine.
I mean the internet.
Cut diagonally.
The internet.
And let's reveal.
We have to try it, right? Next week?
Yeah.
Yes.
Do we want to
do this whole thing?
Here it is. And now, the taste test.
I want to do the roll for sandwich. I already told Scott that.
Let's just get all of our sandwich ingredients together.
This guy's funny.
This is bananas. Easily. A straight 5 out of 5 easy chairs. 10 out of 10, absolutely.
We have to try it, right? Everybody is saying it's a 10 out of 10. It can't be a 10 out of 10, but it has to be. I'm conflicted.
Riley, did you see that sandwich? Did you see that sandwich that...
I don't watch, so I can watch them live on the podcast.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. So we're probably going to see it. Also, here's Marcus Park.
I would love to watch the She-Hulk. It reminds me of my daughter, Sasha. She's smart and tall and in the MCU.
Like Marvel?
Yeah, sure. Yeah.
Oh, go high. Good for you.
Yeah.
Wrestling roll call, Micro Rocker. Ivar the Micro. Into the giant.
This guy's not a fucking midget.
Just a small dude.
He's just a small guy, but he's a big. He weighs like 400 pounds, but he's like 5'1".
He's a big guy.
They call him Andrew the Giant. You can't have an Andre the Giant type character in micro wrestling. No,
because what do you mean? It's like the easiest person. Role to fill.
Yeah, it's a human. It's like if I showed up and I was like, "I'm Andre the
Don't
Giant."
Don't say it like that. It's so cute. Don't say it like.
Riley really just called little people subhuman.
No, I'm saying if they, you can't have an Andre the Giant sized person. That's just a person.
Yeah, dude. Oh. It's never been easier to get into little people wrestling.
Apparently, Andrew the Giant has proved that.
Psycho. Baby TV.
Dude, Psycho scares me.
Psycho scares me too.
Psycho haunts my nightmares.
Luscious Lori. Ugh, Luscious Lori's new, and I am not a fan.
What's the
pink?
Disco Down, baby.
Disco Down.
Flying Ryan.
Flying Ryan's also new. Not a fan.
I don't like.
Why?
Wait, what?
What did he say his name was?
Old man, Little Kato. Flying Ryan.
Lee. Lee.
He didn't even wait till the camera got to him.
Dude, he doesn't have a name
Lee,
yet.
What
he
are
hasn't
you doing?
Heard a name yet.
How about like
anything?
No.
Anything other than those three letters.
Fuck.
My name's Psycho. I'm Pinky Shortcakes. I'm Disco Dom. Lee.
Paul.
Maybe he's not even supposed to be there.
That's fair.
That's yeah.
Old man, Little Kato.
That's a terror. That might. You know what? Lee might be a better name than Old Man Little Kato.
It's such
it
a
was.
Weird
Paul,
combination.
Yeah, fuck that guy.
Yeah. Fuck you,
foosballer.
Old man. Fuck you, Old Man Little Kato. Just one time for good measure.
I love this video.
You can't fall that much if you're the president. He's
dude,
falling.
It ends so fast.
Did he
He's
die?
Fallen.
Well, yeah, obviously.
Did he die?
I
you don't
like
think you hear
heard.
About that if the president of the United
hey,
States died?
It looked like he might have hurt himself pretty bad. I don't know.
This
why are you bullying
though?
Will?
I'm sorry. FPAP got me going.
It's so. It's so.
Joe
weird.
Biden has died. Not died. Has fallen. He's fallen.
9/11
many...
was an inside job.
He's fallen too many times for a U.S. president. It's unacceptable.
Yeah. Yeah. That's, okay. I agree with that.
You this can't... is why the U.S. is a joke.
All right. Let's watch some sandwiches.
It really fucking
could be the sandwich.
Good afternoon, D&D, TikTok, and beyond, and welcome to Roll for Sandwich, the series where I let fate decide my lunch. Let's go.
Let's go.
Today I'll be using these awesome rainbow dice that were sent in by a viewer. First up, roll for bread. 6, ciabatta. Not a bad start overall.
That's a good bread.
Ciabatta's that's a great
favorite bread.
Bread.
It's mostly a texture thing for me, but it is what it is. Next up, roll for main.
Chewy bread.
11, roll twice. All right, here Ooh. We go. 5, smoked ham, and 9, garlic bologna.
That sounds
all right, well,
delicious.
Bologna and ham just gives us a basic cold-cut sandwich.
That
and then the garlic
incredible.
And the smoke will just give us a nice bonus. So far,
go,
pretty normal, but we got a ways to go yet.
A lot,
next
baby.
Up, roll for cheese. 2, baby Swiss. Baby Swiss is similar
yes.
to regular Swiss cheese, but milder because it's aged for less time.
Double your roughage, double your fun.
6, pickles, and 10, jalapenos.
Ooh.
All right, this is pretty close to my go-to on a sandwich like this, except maybe I would have mild peppers instead of jalapenos. The acid from the brine does a great job at cutting the richness
this
of the
is
fatty
a great
lunch
sandwich
meats.
So
they'll
so
both
far.
Be
this
welcome
is,
additions
that's
to this
a
sandwich.
Lot of,
let's
like,
roll wild magic.
Vinegar on that
3,
sandwich,
Old
though.
Bay seasoning. All right, well, I know it's good on seafood, but we'll see how it is here. All right, now it's time for the D20 sauce roll. 13, spruce tip jam. Well, I wrote
what
it down wrong.
Mean?
It was spruce tip jelly. But anyway, it's jelly made from spruce trees. Ooh. Honestly, I was expecting
yeah.
it to taste like one of those pine tree air fryers.
That sounds gross.
Yeah, it doesn't
that sound sounds right. real gross.
Yeah, that sounds disgusting.
Why does he own that?
But it's actually just slightly sweet with just a little aftertaste of earthy botanical
tree.
Something. Ugh. It's interesting. Not sure how it's going to pair here,
this
though.
This still
we'll
seems
see.
Like a dope sandwich.
All right, let's get our toothpicks in place, make sure our sandwich stays together. And let's get it cut.
This is too much cutting.
It's
more
it's
editing.
The texture.
All right, there we go. And let's take a look at that cross section.
That's a good sandwich.
Not bad.
That's a good sandwich.
I wish there was a better sauce.
I really don't know what this is going to taste like. All right, let's give it a go. Okay.
This is interesting. It's kind of in the middle. That spruce tip jelly kind of turned my dill pickles into a more bread and butter tasting pickle. And I think it would have been better on a different bread. The ciabatta made it hard to evenly distribute the spruce jelly, which I think would have helped. Well, they all can't be amazing. That's just the nature of the game. I think a 6.5 is fair for this one.
Okay.
Spruce tip jelly
that
was
shaped
interesting.
Up to be
exactly
so much worse
it,
than
it didn't
sounded.
Help.
I think it's because of the jelly.
Yeah,
the jelly really
ruined
it.
Yeah.
D20 sauce roll.
All right, let's do one more here.
D&D, TikTok, and beyond. Welcome to Roll for Sandwich, the series where I let fate decide my lunch. Let's go. After my editing problems yesterday, I'm going back to the Lucky Ducks. Let's roll for bread. One tortilla.
Let's go.
One flour tortilla.
I've never seen a tortilla.
Let's keep going.
And in the wide words of Jack Hackler, I could eat anything in a tortilla.
Eight chicken.
Oh, there you go.
Today for chicken, I have a buffalo style chicken. So the cayenne is coming out to play.
Cayenne chicken.
Next up, roll for cheese.
I
want
to see how he styles his
five
tortilla.
Havarti. Mild
just,
and creamy to offset the slight spice of the chicken.
Close it.
So far, so good. All right, 2d12 roughage. Here we go. Two cucumber and four green pepper. Use our mandolin
just
here to slice up some cucumbers nice and thin and get a layer put down here.
I want
not
that
adding
machine.
A whole ton flavor-wise, but it'll give us a nice cool crunch. Then moving on to the green peppers, which I already had sliced up. I feel like these occupy a similar flavor zone to the cucumbers. If I were making this by choice, I would have picked a different vegetable. All right, our first chance at real chaos. Here's the wild magic roll. 16, scrambled egg.
What?
Apparently the dice gods Whoa. Didn't think I had enough protein. So all right, two eggs scrambled, added to our wrap. Here we go.
My God.
Man, that's bigger than I thought. Hopefully I'll be able to close it. All right,
I fucked with it.
20 sauce roll, here we go. 17 yum yum sauce. All right, well, yum yum sauce is not the worst thing we could have rolled.
Like if
we'll
you go to Hibachi, the lighter sauce to dip seafood in.
It's just called yum yum sauce.
It is, yes.
Yes, yeah, it is.
It's delicious.
Didn't know that. Is it
new here?
Yum yum.
And yep, as previously mentioned, this is too big to roll up the way that I want to, so we're just gonna hold it closed with our toothpicks here. And let's get it cut.
Seems kind of dope, not gonna lie.
And let's take a look at that cross section. Not bad.
I just think the egg
All
is
right.
out of place.
Not sure how this one's gonna be.
I
We're
agree.
Just gonna
the
dive
egg
right
does
in.
Seem kind of out of place.
He agrees.
All right. Okay. This is okay. The sauce honestly doesn't come through that much. And the egg, cucumber, and green pepper all together kind of wash away the buffalo chicken flavor as well. I think this really would have benefited from a more flavorful vegetable like onions or pickles or jalapenos. Or just a sauce with a little bit more going on than the yum yum sauce.
I really give him credit for
as
powering through.
As is, it's just kind of bland, unfortunately.
Each sandwich,
I think
man.
I'm going to have to go with a 5.9 on this one. I think the egg really threw off the balance. Without the egg, it probably would have been a lot higher.
Yeah.
He powers through each time.
Listen, he's got to eat the sandwiches. It's
love
a
him.
Shtick. He's getting
yeah, dude, it's lunch.
He's getting very that's true.
I love it.
He's getting very popular from it. You know, you got to finish your sandwiches if you're getting some fame. Will,
he's part of the Clean Plate Club.
William, any final words?
Stay moist.
Okay. Ramon, you want to plug your TikTok or anything else you got going on your YouTube page?
No, again, it's just my TikTok page with Mel Daxton. Which I don't know if I ever told you to this before. Maybe I did. Is the name I would go by if I was a supervillain.
Like that?
I like
that. And I haven't actually put anything on my YouTube page in a while. You can go to it if you want. Again, that's fine with me. But, yeah.
Word. And,
Word. Thanks for coming on today, by the way.
Of course.
Yeah, no problem.
I'm looking for a Thanks. Sound.
Oh.
All right. Well, we're going to get on out of here.
Bah.
But we've had ourselves a good time having you here tonight, everybody. Thank you all. Will's dancing. Thank you all for coming out. Go to innercirclepn.com for all things Inner Circle. Go to adamandeve.com. Use promo code PLUNGE at checkout for 50% off and 10 free gifts. Go to official.com, O-H-F-I-S-H-L, like the fish, and jump in 25% off. Go to plungepodcast.com for all things podcast. Go to patreon.com/theplunge. Go check out our Twitch. We're affiliates now, so go subscribe. Give us them sweet Bezos dollars, and we will catch you all next week.
Don't forget to stay moist.
Stay moist.